Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Well, the bodies are gone. Totally decomposed. Our friends are dead. Oh, I didn't take the items that they were holding. That's not fair. I forgot. I only took the items they had in their general inventory, not what they were wearing. I think we have all the potions. No. Hiodan had one of them. Okay. Well, last episode, our companions died in a scripted encounter. There's some kind of... Yeah. There was a ritual over here with the life essences. We're being drawn into this thing. And, just witnessing that killed our friends. But then we leveled up, so.
Time to see and not be seen.
And now we have this affliction. Apparently, well. Ooh! We hear voices and apparently see things as well. Liking. So what happens when we approach this thing exactly? Okay. So we hear voices and we see phantasms. Lovely. Just lovely. Okay, I can't make the map, the screen advance further. Still in Silent Less. There's a road south over here. It actually scared me. Do I dare? Vessel flesh was added to the stash? Oh. Extra items that cannot fit into the inventory. Yeah, special, okay. Yeah, I pretty much knew that. Is it an alchemy thing? Vessel flesh. This reeking flesh once held a bound soul. With its energy fading, the flesh is entering a rapid decay. Is this going to change after time, over time? I guess I can get more vessel flesh. Oh my gosh, people are getting like tortured. Now, if I approach it, it goes away, right? I can't even look at it. You know, all I can do is just advance to it, towards it. Or not. Okay, so we have vessel flesh here. The massive structure is formed of stone adra and copper and covered in strange glyphs. The air around it vibrates with an unusual energy. Pilgrim's crown. These small golden flowers grow across entire meadows in the plains of Ixamatil. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. I don't think we've heard it pronounced in game yet. And less commonly in the Deerwood, they are frequently woven into garlands and wreaths. Many a pair of infatuated youths has passed a pilgrim's crown between them. Oh, how sweet. in the midst of all this decay and ghostly crap. We find that. That means there's hope in the world, right? No? What do you mean no? What should we do? Go in? Can we go in? Is there something we can go in? No. I can't advance further than that. Not trusting, because I don't know where this guy is who was performing the rites. He might be hanging out somewhere. Now, if we leave this place and go down the road, are we still going to see these phantasms? Because it's going to get annoying after a while. Alright, let's go. To the road! Okay, Defiance Bay. I like that. Valewood, Gilded Veil. I can't go there, can I? I have to go to Valewood first. We're supposed to go to Gilded Veil, I believe, to cure our affliction. I want to go that way. I can't. Deerford Village. Chanters can do more than just chant. While their abilities are not focused on frontline combat,
they're competent down here.
Warriors. Should we bed down here? Yeah, let's do it. It's our last set of camping supplies, but we have major fatigue, minus 10 to all defenses, minus 20 to accuracy, and 0.75 maximum endurance. We need rest. Oh, now we gotta get sinister dreams when we rest. Okay, that wasn't that bad though, it was just weird. I never trust when there's a body, like someone's waiting for us to come up and bend down and then... Oh good, more camping supplies. Leather armor. Admeth's wort. Is that something we have already? Yeah. It's pretty much we just got another one here. Well, if you guys are curious. That's what it is. What it is. Alright. It's just me. I'm no longer fatigued. But yeah, I really wanna... What? Who's this? I saw that. I definitely saw that. We're going to keep seeing spooky things, aren't we, until we fix this affliction. Blood moss. I wonder if there's a way to actually look at it first before we pick it up. This moss grows in sprawling clumps, and its dull crimson hue earned it its name. It is a common sight in more humid regions, where locals say that the moss resembles wounds at the base of trees where it is found. How delightful. Nothing to look at here. I keep hitting tab to see if there's selectable stuff, and nothing. See that? Game is trying to play tricks with us. Who's that? Is someone dead or asleep? River reed. This place, are these woods haunted? Maybe these specters we're seeing has nothing to do with the affliction that we have. I wonder if we could see more, you know, any information on this affliction. These tall reeds grow along the creeks and rivers of the Deerwood, where they often spook travelers with the eerie whistle of the wind through their stems. Can't go in here. I can go around, and that's just gonna make me go that way. Can't go that way. Oh. Outlaw. Damage. Come to mama. Okay. That's, what do you call it again? Mind wave. Takes a while to cast this stuff. Oh, he's almost dead now. Why am I... I switched weapons. I did that. I switched weapons. What the hell is this game up to? There's a sword. Just like the one I have already. Oh, that's a small shield. Leather armor. An open helm. Okay, this is what we have. Copper panned. A high-volume deer wooden currency used in everyday trade and is the basis for most transactions. Yeah, we should wear this. Why is it not telling me... if it changes any of these numbers. I don't see it makes much difference. Or any difference, actually. Well, that wasn't bad at all. Hold on, where am I running off to? It's just like these games, if you click on somewhere your party, your member, or, well, your party can't automatically get to, they end up taking this circuitous route Oh, cool. People. Friendly people. How long does it take to make some damn stew? Yeah, and they end up blundering into... Don't rush me. You have to let the meat absorb the flavor. They end up rushing into danger. You'll beat what? The young dwarf, his name's Tenfrith, tending to the stew, looks up, startled. As he sees you approach, he drops his ladle, spattering stew across the ground. What? The bandit turns. Get her, you dogs, and make sure our new cook don't run off. What? Help, please, help. One of the bandits gives Tenfrith a kick as you pass him, and he huddles. It's only me. No. Tenfrith, help me. What's this symbol mean? Bandit, outlaw, bandit. This could be nasty. At least that one's not running up. He's firing at me. How tough is this guy? He's still 2 points. Weapon ineffective. I'm using a sword. Why is it ineffective? Plus 56. That'd kind of be a waste of it. It's like I'll only get to 40. At least what do I get to load down lower? Like halfway or something. You know what? Here. Can I use this again? I miss my friends. They help me with the stuff. Endurance. Oh, that helps. Why does he have more? I'll have to use that again in a second. These guys are tough. Oh boy. J- Should I take this? I mean, how tough are these guys? Is the outlaw the hardest one? Outlaw is badly injured. What does this mean, 17? Defenses. Did I take it? I think I took it. I think. It's still there, though. I don't get it. He's still- I'm barely injuring this guy. I guess I should run. What? I'm fighting again. No, run! Yeah, because I'm not fighting, I'm running. No! Is that me fighting? I'm still fighting him. Game. Game, I'm running. I was running. So the game won't let me run away from foes. I keep turning around and fighting anyway. Okay, I'm gonna pause this and go through everything I did before. See you on the flip side. Okay. I collected all the items I did before. I just killed the one outlaw that was not part of that scene. And, this one had something different. A Carrogolan? Made from a secret and uncommon plant that grows deep in Ir Glanfath. Carrogolan is the name given to a mixture typically used solely for ceremonial purposes, or else by warriors going into important battles. It is said to open one's awareness to one's place in the world, raising one's ability to recognize and react to threats. Cool. Put in with my other stuff. I put the helmet back on her. I'm gonna not go that way. I'm pretty sure that's where they were. Over here somewhere. So.
Time to see and not be seen.
Yeah, it's smart. Yeah, I need to find a party. Because that's really tough for one person to be going up against. Especially when the game doesn't behave correctly. I mean, if I tell you to run, frickin' run. Don't turn around and fight more when you're almost frickin' dead. Northwest to Garen's Grasp, south to Gilded Vale. Well, we do need to go to Gilded Vale. Nanton? Hello, Nanton? Come on. The man appears to be hurriedly dismantling his camp in quick, jerky movements. He looks up as you approach, his expression tense and drawn. Greetings, he says, a little breathless. On your way south, is it? I'm not sure what he said, but I don't think it was greetings. You look to be a long way from home, meaning no offense. Not sure what brought you down here, but it's no place to go wandering alone. Yes, please join me and fight some bandits with me. He wipes his brow, turning to face you. The sooner you're clear of these woods, the better, I think. Caravan was attacked. Never mind the woods. Strange machine. It's your hurry. Passing through. Oh, keep your nose in your own business. Regrets lopped off. Now let's cut right to the chase. Never mind the woods. There's a strange machine in the ruins up north. There were these figures clad in black performing some kind of rite. The man's brows furrow in concern. Ruins? The old Ingwithin place? You'll want to keep clear of those, whatever you saw. Strange things always crop up around Ingwithin sites. I don't doubt those people you saw are up to no good. Yeah, neither do I. Sorry, guys. Let the Glanfathans deal with it. They don't take kindly to trespassers, whatever their intentions, and there's enough to worry about in these woods as it is. His expression falls. We came across a bear in a cave to the north. Got the better of a friend of mine. I only just made it out with my life. In any case, the forest already cost me a friend. I'm heading home before it takes anything else. Who are you? Name's Nanton. Born and raised in Gilded Vale. Having a spot of luck since. His face twists. Luckier than Pearly, I suppose. What happened to your friend? Obviously mauled by a bear. We didn't see it coming. Nanton's voice shakes a little as he speaks. We were following a stag. Pearly, he saw something in the brambles and went tearing off after it. We all but stumbled into the cave. Poor Pearly didn't stand a chance. The bear was on top of him before we knew it was happening. The beasts will take what they will, I suppose. He smiles sadly. And this time, Galloway's favor fell upon the bear. Where did you find this bear? In a cave, ways up that way. He turns to point to the northwest. I wouldn't seek it out if I were you. It was a great brute of a beast. Would hate to hear that it took another life. Farewell. Can I talk to him
Greetings.
Some more? Alright. Should we fight this bear? Let's save here before we die. Valewood. I actually want to make control key. Is the control key used for something else? Toggle scouting. Is left alt. Control H is HUD.
Time to see and not be seen.
Is that eye always there? The grass is still flattened behind the wagon's wheels. Barrels of cabbages, potatoes, and squash have been overturned and abandoned. Oh wait, got something here. Oh, good. Another camping supply. Hunting bow and 5 copper. Oh, I can circle around and see what that's on that body. More river reed. Young wolf.
After him!
Wait. This. Are you gonna fire at him? Okay, good. Oh my god, this just doesn't work correctly sometimes. Useless. Are you going to cast your spell? Oh my god. We got jibs. Wolf hide. The wolves of the Deerwood are a large and crafty breed, bereft of the species' usual shyness, and they present a casual... Guys, it's time for my bedtime. I'm very sorry. They present a serious hazard to travelers who venture off the beaten path. Hunters who seek them out will not usually contend with a single wolf, for they travel in packs of varying size, presenting a challenge to any lone hunter. Their furry hides are valued for the warmth they can provide, and the teeth of the strongest wolves make for impressive trophies. I think I have read that before. Look at the jibs. I guess I killed it that badly. Shattered pieces of a crate are strewn across the dirt, along with a few muddy vegetables. I can't look at this? Why not? Well, that's stupid. We could look at it before, when it wasn't...
Quickly and quietly.
When we were on the other side of the road. See, why is that eye not there now? Oh, what's this? I think we have some of that stuff. Whatever that is. Settler's arrow? Oh no, I don't think so. It looked like that. These distinctive mushrooms are shaped like arrowheads protruding from the side of tree trunks. Well, that was not a tree trunk. Those were rocks. Some more amethyst work. Oh, is a Zorup camp? Where? Across the way or over here? I don't see any camp. There's the bear cave. There's a Zorup camp. Yeah, it's a cross. I don't even know how I get there from where I am. Still have this area to explore. So stay tuned for next episode when we investigate the bear camp and hopefully kill us a bear and not get killed. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.